हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू एंड वेलकम बैक आवर ऑनलाइन क्लास साइंस 7th स्टैंडर्ड। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू आवर सेकंड चैप्टर दैट इज द न्यूट्रिशन इन एनिमल्स। सो इन द लास्ट आई मीन प्रीवियस वीडियो ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट दैट व्हाट इज द न्यूट्रिशन इन ह्यूमंस। यस, देयर आर सेवन ऑर्गन्स लाइक एलिमेंट्री कैनाल, हाउ लाइक देयर फूड्स आर डाइजेस्टिंग, हाउ दैट यूटिलाइजिंग असिमिलेशन ड्यूरिंग एंड हाउ लाइक डाइजेशन, व्हाटएवर दैट ऑल द थिंग्स फ्रॉम द injection to ejection we have already discussed in the previous videos. But friends, today we are going to discuss about that one special other things that is called as grass eating animal nutrition. Okay, that means how that grass eating animals like a cow, deer, that how they are doing that nutrition, or how they are absorbing the foods, or how they are taking the foods, and how the foods are digesting in their stomachs. So today we are going to discuss about that special features of the nutrition in grass eating animals. Okay students, so students, you know that sometimes you have observed whenever that cows or the deer or that buffaloes, sometimes simply whenever they are sleeping time, their mouth, they are doing just like eating the grass or eating the fodder. Yes, have you seen that they are just their mouth just working like they are doing just like something they are eating? Why they are doing like that? Did you observe that? Yes students, that is their even mechanism, their even working that they are doing. Because whenever they are taking the fodder, that means whenever they are taking that food, like a grass or any food, plants or any leaves or anything, at that time they took very soon. Okay, so that food is they kept in their one particular one stomach area, and that is called as rumen. And that rumen, from that, whenever they will take rest, at that time the food is taking out to mouth, and they are doing that chewing. Okay, so that is one of the method that is for that only for rumination purposes is there. So that is for that ruminant, those animals are there, they can do this. Okay, so how the process is taking place and thoroughly we will discuss in this video. So let us start that what are the mechanisms or the what are the process and what are the different digestive systems in the grass eating animals, we will discuss in this video. So let us see students. First of all, I will explain to you that look at here, nutrition in grass eating animals, how like that nutrition in humans, like the food is entering the mouth, then after esophagus, then after stomach, then small intestine, then after going to that large intestine, then after rectum, then anus, how like the replacement is going to take place in the five phases, same like friends. But it is in the nutrition in grass eating animals. The grass eating animals like cows, buffalo, deer, like herbivores, especially you can say. That animals is different. That is one unique special methods they are doing for this nutrition. Okay, so let us see that how they are different from the humans. Okay, from the humans. The grass eating animals have a unique method of digesting cellulose. Particularly cellulose means, cellulose means generally what is that, it is one many polymers. Okay, cellulose means many polymers are in nature. That you have seen that wood, okay, cotton, okay, and these are the contents that cellulose. Okay, cellulose is one chemical substance like, and which one special the polymer. Okay, many polymers are made of that cellulose, and you will go higher class in study about that. Especially cellulose means it is the one of the many polymers found in nature. Wood, paper, cotton contains cellulose. Especially if you see that wood, paper and cotton, okay, and this contains the cellulose. Especially grass is rich in a specific carbohydrates called cellulose. Okay, in grass also contain one type of carbohydrates, that is special, that is called as also cellulose. Okay, so this is cellulose. What is that? It is eaten by the grass eating animals like cows, buffaloes, deer. Okay, so these are all the things how they are digesting in the and that like grass eating animals, we will discuss. It is very difficult for us students. So if we will take that grass, can we digest? No students, we have no capable or such digestive system in our stomach or in our body to digest this cellulose. So that's why we cannot digest that. If you take that some grass, then we cannot digest, because it contains specially one type of special carbohydrates, that is cellulose. Cellulose we cannot digest. That system or digestive system is not present in our body. It is specially one unique method or unique special digestion system is present in the grass eating animals that we are going to learn. Okay. So now see, the grass eating animals quickly swallow the fodder and store it in a separate part of the stomach called rumen. Students, very carefully remember. Whenever one deer
is observing, you have seen that whenever that it is taking that grazing that grass, at that time she is in fear. That means sometimes she is feeling that it is feeling somebody will attack to me. Suppose those who are that prayers, that means they will attack tiger, lion, or other animals, they will attack. That's why very fear with the fear. Soon, very soon, they will take that photos or they will take that grass. And whenever it is over, then after they will go to one safe place where nobody can attack to them. Or that place, they will take out that grass to mouth and they will chew. Then after it will go to that again stomach. So whenever they will take, when they very soon, very quickly, when they will eat that grass or they will graze, at that time, that plant, that grass will store in the one particular stomach that is called as a rumen. Okay. So store it in the separate part of the stomach that is called as a rumen. In the rumen. In the rumen, food is partially digested. The partially digested food is called cod. Remember the students? Cod. That means she would record. So whenever that food will graze and that or the fodder, whenever that will be grazed by that grass eating animal, that it will store in that one particular one special stomach there, that is called as a rumen, and there in that rumen that partial digestion will take place. Okay, that is called as a curd, suri. How late will that partial digestion will come? That food will come to the mouth and that it will do chewing by that animal. Okay, then it will store that is called as special, that one process is called as, that is called as a rumination. What is that? The process of that chewing of the curd is called as a rumination. That means whenever it will store in the stomach or the rumen, after whenever that animal feels it is now safe, at that time that animal will do that chewing, that food. Rumen, again that food will come through the mouth. We can very carefully try to understand. Whenever that food will graze and it will go and it will suddenly quickly it will store in that one stomach, whenever it needs to that chewing, at that time it will take it again back to mouth, again it will be chewing in that process is called as a rumination, and that animal is called as a ruminants. Okay, so see that students, rumination kya hoga, the process of chewing the curd is called rumination and the animals are called ruminants. This process, which process? When that curd means what? The food is quickly storing in the stomach, the rumen, that is called a general cord, because that cord will come to that agar mouth and it will be chewing. Okay, that process is called as a rumination, and those animals are doing, that animals are called as a ruminants. Okay, stomach in ruminants is different from the human stomach. If you see that grass eating animals like ruminants, their stomach and human stomach are far different. Okay, so in the ruminants, the stomachs generally are 4 chambers. Okay, if you see that the stomach of that ruminants, there contains how many chambers? 4 chambers. Our only one chamber, only one sac, that is called as stomach. But in the ruminants, grass eating animals, stomach has 4 chambers. What are that? One is rumen, first one, when that food quickly will store. Thereafter reticulum, that another one, second part of that stomach, omasum and abomasum. Okay, these are the 4 types, 4 chambers, okay, of one stomach of the ruminants or the grass eating animals. What are that? First of all, once you remember this, rumen, second one is what is that? Reticulum. Next, third one is omasum and fourth one is abomasum. Did you remember that? Once repeat with me. First one is what is that? Rumen. Second one is reticulum. Third one is omasum. Fourth one is abomasum. So these 4 parts or chambers generally present in the ruminants, those are grass eating animals. So we'll discuss one by one, what is that rumen, what is that reticulum, what is the omasum, what is the abomasum. We'll discuss one by one. So first of all, we'll discuss what is that rumen. In the first chamber of ruminant stomach is called rumen, the first chamber. Okay, in the grass eating animals or the ruminants, the first chamber where the food first, whenever the grass eating animals will take that food first quickly, whenever it will eat, that food will go and store in that rumen, the first chamber that is. It is the largest chamber. Okay, whenever that if you compare to the four chambers, the largest chamber is called as a rumen. Food is stored in this chamber, and also digestion cellulose also take place here. Whatever the cellulose, whatever the grass that the animals are taking, that partial digestion will take place in this rumen. From the rumen, food is entered to the second chamber, that is called as the reticulum. Then after, it will go to the second chamber. Okay, that is called as the reticulum. Okay, after the partial digestion, after the chewing that food, that rumination process completely after that, it will go to the second chamber. And especially first chamber and second chamber, there is correlated to each other. Okay, there is an open place and they can close to each other. Okay, so these are about that specially rumen, and whatever that about that reticulum, ovumosum, omasum, that we will discuss with that figures with you. I will explain in the upcoming videos. Thank you all of you. Have a nice day.